should have brought my glasses. L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone you can adore. And love is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game or two. Two in love can make it. Here's my heart, so please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Grab that person that you love and don't forget to tell them that you love them. Sometimes you can call them up on the phone, send them a text message, send them flowers, chocolates, candies, it doesn't matter. Sometimes even a nice crisp high five is enough to just remind somebody that you love them. Don't let a day go by without telling somebody that you want them in your life. Oh, L is for the way you look at me. Oh, is for the only one I see. OV is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you can adore. And love is all that I can give to you. Oh, love is more than just a game or two. Two in love can make it. So here's my heart, baby, please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Oh, love was made for me and you. Oh, love was made for me and you.
Good evening, folks, and thank you so much for joining us. My name is Will Akins.
And my name is Jacob Reinhardt.
And welcome to our virtual Valentine Day Cabaret. Now, we understand that this year, Valentine's Day is looking a little different, as usual. So we decided to do something, well, with the times. We decided to bring to you a collection of pieces and songs that revolve around love, or maybe lost love, or maybe even sometimes how love just kind of attaches itself to you, and present them to you in a very virtual manner. So
this Valentine's Day is up to par with the rest of mine. So.
But you're not a Valentine.
I'm not alone this time. I have you with me.
We're not alone in being alone.
Yeah, everyone, we're alone together.
We're alone together. So we wanted to just, you know, present something very special for you all. We wanted to let you know that the folks that are singing for you tonight were very carefully chosen. Just so, you know, we could be in a close environment with each other and not have to wear masks. But we do ask that, you know, you continue to respect all of the guidelines and stuff so that we can get back to gathering together and performing in theater and things.
Hopefully pretty soon.
Hopefully extremely, extremely soon. So that first piece was Love. That arrangement was the Natalie King Cole version. And the rest of the cast is super excited to bring to you everything that we have to present for you. So please stick around. If you have dedications you would like to make, go ahead and make them in the little comment box down there. And we will try to make dedications and things. And what do we got first, Jake?
We seem to have... I closed your notes.
That's okay.
First, we have a song that's dedicated to Marjorie Reinhardt. It's a song that I really hope she'll like, and we have Miss Cassidy Kuntz singing to it, and we hope she'll like it.
So this first song is dedicated to you, Grandma Reinhardt, from all of your real grandchildren, your adopted grandchildren, and everyone who loves you. Here is If I Loved You. thank you so much, Cassidy. That was actually, I've always really liked that song.
Yeah, I'm more amazed we got the stage changed so fast.
And also, we had a very special dedication to Mr. Kevin Bartley, Love Debbie. So Mrs. Debbie would like to dedicate that song to you, Kevin. As we said, if you want to make dedications and things like that, we will do our best to try to announce them throughout the program this evening. You know, or maybe if there's that special song that you kind of want to hear, maybe you never know if we sneak it in there or slip it in there or, you know, give you a line or two out of it. So we want to make this as inclusive as possible. So, yeah, how's your grandmother been? Actually, I know a lot of people would like to know.
She's really good. My dad and I went over the other day, and we got her on a bike pedal thing.
Cool.
So we're keeping her moving, whether she likes it or not.
Cool.
And her reward is cookies whenever she does that. So
wait, but
positive reinforcement.
Who makes the cookies? You make the cookies?
Oh, my mom makes the cookies.
Okay. All right.
Or my dad makes them by buying them from Walgreens.
Well, we all know how Uncle Mike makes the cookies. Positive reinforcement. I'm going to call you Pavlov.
Pavlov's grandma.
Pavlov's grandma. All right. Well, you know, thinking about all of this time, you know, we all want to feel loved and we want to feel special, and there's always that special someone. And sometimes it really does take the love of that special someone for you to, you know, go down this journey of life. So this next song is going to be It Takes Two, as performed by Mr. Jacob Reinhardt and Miss Cassidy Koontz from the musical Into the Woods.
You've changed, you're daring, you're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing, you're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough, it's not true. It takes two of you, you came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us, it takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Oh, you swear to change, who can tell if you do? It takes two.
You've changed, you're thriving. There's something about the woods. Not just surviving, you're blossoming in the woods. At home, I fear we'd stay the same forever. And then out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It's one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us, each accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed, we're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And once we've passed, let's hope the changes last. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoods, just the two of us, beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us,
it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we had none, we've got three. It means one. It takes two.
Where does she go? Where can she be? When will she come again? Calling to me. Calling to me. to me. Somewhere there's a girl who's like the glimmer of the wind upon the water. Somewhere there's a girl who's like the shimmer of the sunlight on the sea. Somewhere there's a girl who's like a swell of endless music. Somewhere she's singing and her song is meant for me. And her voice, sweet as angels sighing. And her voice, it's warm as summer sky. And that sound, it haunts my dreams and spins me round until it seems I'm flying. Her voice.
Still nothing. With all due respect, sire, we've been scouring the sea for weeks, and to what end?
I'm about to find her, and I will.
Wait, I've got a better idea. On the eve of your 21st birthday, we'll host a marvelous ball. We'll invite countless eligible young ladies.
I knew it.
To sing for you.
What?
Yes, a contest. What better way to find your mysterious voice? Why, we'll have you married before sunset that very day, just as your father agreed.
Of course,
agreed.
That's how we'll find her.
Yes, indeed.
I can sense her laughter in the ripple of the waves against the shoreline. I can see her smiling in the moonlight as it settles on the sand. I can feel her waiting just beyond the pale horizon, singing out a melody too lovely to withstand. And her voice, it's there as dusk is falling. And her voice, it's there as dawn steals by. Pure and bright, it's always near, all day or night, still I hear it calling. Her voice, strange as a dream, real as the sea. If you can hear me now, come set me free. Come set me free.
I've always actually personally liked that song. So that, as you saw, had scenes in it from the last summer show that we were actually able to do, and that was Little Mermaid in what feels like
last year. But there's a whole year in between now and then. So
a year?
Yeah.
Last year was the longest decade of my life.
Yeah.
and we really did miss not doing a summer production. For a lot of us, that was, you know, what we really looked forward to throughout the year. Getting to not only hang out with our friends, but, you know, doing the rehearsal process and all the things that came out with it. I mean, we would hang out practically after that show every night, you know.
Yeah, with two extra people. Now we do that by ourselves.
Yeah. We really do look forward to getting back to it. And just like everyone else, the pandemic has affected us here. And if you can find it in your heart to donate, we would really appreciate that so that we can continue to bring you that professional quality theater to Northwest Indiana. There is a donation link available in the comment section here on YouTube, also on the Facebook page, or if you want to, you know, message the Eminem Ross or Ross Music Theater pages to set something up. Once again, we would really appreciate any donation so that we can hopefully start to plan for our next production. So,
I see we have Tim Slatton.
Yeah.
In here.
Tim's watching. Hey, Tim.
Hi, Tim. Long time no see. Hope you're enjoying our Into the Woods. You're going to get some more in a minute. I always liked that song, It Takes Two, because it, you know, kind of really brings that, you know, partnership, and it takes, it's 50-50 on everything. And I especially love about that song is he gets cheated on in the next act. So it meant nothing.
Well.
But a song I do happen to really like from Into the Woods is Agony. And anytime I get to sing that with my brother is fun for everyone else.
Oh, yeah. Cause so. You don't make this stuff up. I think you all just save your love for each other.
We sing it three times and we riff. That's essentially what we do. So up next, we got Agony from Into the Woods and Some Enchanted Evening from Mr. Will.
From South Pacific, yeah. All right, we hope you enjoy.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Life and becoming, frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, all the tortures they teach. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
For everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
This girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness. Till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her ah.
Agony, misery, although it's different for each.
10 steps behind, always 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach.
Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to wife.
Enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. You may see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow you know even there, that somewhere you'll see. Enchanted evening, someone may be laughing. You may hear her laughing across a crowded room, and night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of her laugh will sing in your dreams. Who can explain it? Who can tell me why? Fools give you reasons, wise men never try. Some enchanted evening, when you find your true love, when you find your true love across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. Or all through your life you may dream all alone. Once you have found her, never let her go. Once you have found
first off, we want to apologize for some of the technical errors that are occurring with some of the jerky video. Like we said, we wanted to bring you something virtual, and well, we're a bunch of live theater performers and directors and things. And
unfortunately, me recording Will singing is idiot-proof, and keeping a study video is not my forte.
But we do appreciate all of the love and support that we're seeing in the comments section. Thank you so much to Missy Gonzalez for always being very supportive. Also to Jalen Halliburton.
Put us on his Snapchat story.
Oh, he put us on his Snapchat? Oh.
We made it big time.
For always, you know, those folks who are always supporting us. And, we couldn't thank you enough. And without you folks, well, a lot of this stuff would be kind of for nothing. It'd just be for our enjoyment at that point in time, and we want to share our gifts and our love for music and theater with you all, because you know that's what we love to do.
Before that, I did get one request that I'm afraid I cannot fulfill because they requested a song from Big Mouth, and this is PG-13 or PG most of the time, so I can't do that. I very much apologize, but up next there's a song that I've listened to for a long time, and I never really had a chance to sing it, and Will helped play it for me, and I did it to the best of my ability with the dry weather and scratchy throat that we're all dealing with now, just because sinuses and the weather. It's a song called You Grew On Me, where it really kind of beats the myth of love happening at first sight, and Tim Minchin himself, who wrote the song, said that he doesn't really believe in that thing that happens at first sight is love, and this is his quote song on that creepy, uppy kind of love. And then right after that, you'll hear from us again.
Yeah, which, you know, I think it's funny that we're doing this right after some enchanted evening, because we went from, oh, you're going to see someone and you're going to instantly fall in love, and you're like, reality check. Just like Into the Woods, you know.
Yeah.
They'd sing about how much it takes a partnership, and then she goes off and does what she does. So this is You Grew On Me by Tim Minchin.
Kind of set to a little bit of a skit going on. But yeah. Yeah.
Hope you enjoy.
Yeah.
Like a tumor, and you spread through me like malignant melanoma, and now you're in my heart. I should have cut you out back at the start. Now I'm afraid there's no cure for me, no chemotherapy can halt my pathetic decline. I should have had you removed back when you were benign. I picked you up like a virus, like meningococcal meningitis. Now I can't feel my legs. When you're around, I can't get out of bed. I've left it too late to risk an operation. I know there's no hope for a clean amputation. The successful removal of you would probably kill me too. You grew on me like carcinoma, crept up on me like untreated glaucoma. Now I find it hard to see. This untreated dose of you has blinded me. I should have consulted my local physician. I'm stuck now forever with this tunnel vision. My periphery is screwed. Wherever I look now, all I see is you. When we first met, you seemed fickle and shallow, but my armor was no match for your poison arrow. You are wedged inside my breast. If I try to pull you out now, I just might bleed to death. I'm feeling short of breath. You grew on me like a tumor, and you spread through me like malignant melanoma. I guess I never knew how fast a little
like a tumor.
Like a tumor. You like a grew tumor. On me like a tumor.
That was an interesting song.
It is. It's one of those quirky kind of little character songs, and I like the kind of parallels it drew between chronic diseases and being in love
and
with
five
someone.
Five sharps.
Five sharps and developing dependency on others.
I mean, you're...
Like, I depended on you for finding the place in that. And I'm like, where are we?
And I depended on... I don't know what I depended on. I just was just, you know, randomly hitting notes, and they kind of all came together and sounded nice.
As long as you know the key signature. So, Elias is watching. This is what we're talking about.
This is. One of our... we work with a group of homeschool students with Studio 219, Jacob and I.
And they're in the chat right now.
Yeah.
So, we also have, for the people who just tuned in, we should remind them about donations and such.
Yeah. So for those of you that are just joining us, welcome. We're doing a virtual cabaret style thing here with songs about love. Obviously songs about how love happens or how love just attacks you and you don't fall in love when you just see someone across the room. We're doing this because, well, we can't really gather together right now to do the normal style of shows that we do. And so if you can find it in anywhere in your heart to donate, we understand that times are very tough for everyone. Yeah. And We want to get back to doing that theater, because after this is all over, that's what we're really going to need. We're going to need things to gather together.
And as more people get vaccines out, the more, you know, performers we can have on stage at once, the more we can actually put things together and have larger scale things.
Yeah, which is once again why this small group was selected to be with each other, so that we could be in the same room without masks. I mean, Jacob and I are practically together every single day, and so always making sure that we're, you know, respecting the things that need to be respected. But yeah, so speaking of concerts and live theater and things, you know, over the pandemic, many theaters unfortunately did not make it. Some of them did not get to do anything at all. We did put on a Halloween show here, a virtual slash in-person audience with a very small number of folks allowed inside. And then once again, same thing, same concept. It was just the four of us that are always together anyway. Mm-hmm. We got off Little Shop of Horrors.
Yeah, we did.
For Miraville High School.
That was amazing.
the closest thing next to a miracle, which if you know Melinda Reinhardt, anything that she does is a miracle. So, you know, everything. And they're going to be doing Smokey Joe's Cafe over at Miraville High School in April. So please make sure that you are... you know, watching the Facebook and all of those things that we use to use publicity, so that you could hopefully support them virtually, in person, however we can bring that to you. We want to kind of show you, for those of you, maybe there are some of you watching that have never seen something that we've done before, or maybe there are some of you that are just itching, you miss it so much. So we wanted to bring to you a clip from the last full stage musical that Ross Music Theater was able to do. And once again, that was Little Mermaid back in 2019, to where...
it's crazy.
I know. It feels like forever ago. I mean, for you it's been longer, but for me it's been like 10 years solid. I've been doing shows every year for 10 years, but you, all your life.
I came home for spring break, and I'm still on spring break. I haven't gone back to school yet.
Must be nice.
Yeah. But up next, we got One Step Closer from The Little Mermaid, followed up by All I Ask of You from Phantom of the Opera.
Who needs small talk anyway? Nimble on your feet, aren't you? Why, sir. Dancing beats small talk any day. Well, sure, it's the way your feet smile. It's the way your feet laugh. A simple gesture can reveal just so much. Dancing is a language that's felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, go on like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to saying what you feel. Once the music hits you, inhibitions fall away, and you find that you're expressing things your voice didn't say. Don't be afraid, let go. What's inside will sweep on through as the boundaries between us disappear. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to talking loud and clear. And round.
to heart. Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard, but says much more than language ever could. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer, one step closer, one step closer to being understood.
Forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you. Let me be your shelter, let me be your light. You're safe, no one will find you, your fears are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night, and you with me, beside me, to hold me and to hide me.
And say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. Say you need me with you here beside you. Anywhere you go, let me go too. Love me, that's all I ask of
you. Say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Say the words and I will follow you.
Share each day with me, each night, each morning.
you know, that show really just, it's very special to me because that was my first big boy show. I did Scrooge right before that, my freshman year, but, you know, getting to play Monsieur Andre in Phantom was, you know, my first, I think that's when I really got bit by the bug, and I don't think that I could go back. I would go back to that moment and change anything.
Yeah, when I first did Phantom, like, I remember the experience of, I'm like, yeah, I'm going to go to school and I'm going to major in this. And then here I am graduated, still not making money. So I have this sixth sense for the future.
No.
And I just knew I was going to end up broke.
We're giving voice lessons and like that. And,
yeah.
You know. But and then also for Cassidy, because, you know, she played Meg. And I know that Cassidy always tells the story that one of her most magical moments on stage was that last scene in Phantom. She said she had to run off too soon because she felt everything culminate to that one moment. And, you know, that's why I think, I know personally, that's why I love to do this, is because we have those moments to where you just, you know, you feel everything. You know, it's this natural high. So, and what was right before that? Now, and the One Step Closer. I had so much fun in that show.
Aha.
I had so much fun.
I had so many hats on in that show.
No, it wasn't that bad.
I did. There's a scene where the prince is floating in the ocean, and little did they know, Triton was suspending the prince backstage in his costume, holding on for dear life, because if you drop the rope, you drop the lead of the show.
So were you more worried of dropping the lead or more worried of dropping your brother?
No comment.
Once again, I think we should replay Agony, and everyone will laugh more now that you refuse to make a comment. But, you know, that's why we love to do the things that we get to do.
Share those moments with other people. And, like, that's the one thing that's really bugged me personally. I know a lot of other people about the pandemic is, you know, people in the arts, people in theater live this kind of lifestyle where you see each other every day for 6 to 8 weeks, depending on the show. If you're doing Scrooge, then just 2 weeks.
Yeah.
But 6 to 8 weeks.
You walk in, they say, hey, we're going to do Scrooge. When? November 12th. You walk in November 11th with one rehearsal.
And you make it happen. But a lot of this thing is just, I remember last summer, I thought it would be nice at first to just kind of have a summer where I just relax and did nothing. And then I realized doing nothing is really not all that great, because I like the community aspect of coming in and seeing other people, and just like the rest of the world just like melts away for
like
the hour
and a half.
And those
are sometimes the only time that we see those people throughout the, like, we could talk to them, but, you know,
despite our best efforts. Yeah.
And we do cool stuff. That was the summer we went to Indiana Beach. And
we had lots of fun that summer.
Yeah.
And we always, when we do the Disney shows, we have those nice little, we had the tea with Belle, we had the tea with Ariel, stuff like that. We do the 4th of July parades. The whole process is just super fun and was missed majorly last summer.
Yeah. But, you know, and as we've had little small snippets, musical theater is not the only thing that we all sing. We all have a multitude of different likes and interests and talents. So our friend Cassidy Kuntz, I know she was born in the wrong time frame. Like, I'm really happy that we get her now, but she really, really, really does a very nice job. I mean, all the time, but really does a nice job with that 40s style of music. And so here to sing Someone to Watch Over Me is, again, my friend, Miss Cassidy Kuntz.
Is blind, still we're often told, seek and ye shall find. So I'm going to seek a certain man I've had in mind. Looking everywhere, haven't found him yet. He's a big affair I cannot forget. Only man I think of with regret. the somebody I'm longing to see. I hope that he turns out to be someone who'll watch over me. I'm a little lamb who's lost in the woods. I know I could always be good to one who'll watch over me. Although he may not be the man some girls think of as handsome, to my tell him, please, put on some speed. Follow my lead. Oh, how I need someone to watch. Someone to watch.
I've always, always, always loved those old standards. Like, I mean, you know me, I'm a big jazz guy, so I really always love those old standards. But, you know, we do a lot of musical theater here, and that's kind of our thing. So I think it would go, there's a lot of love songs written in musical theater.
Isn't that just that's basically musical theater?
That's basically musical theater. I love them.
There's love songs and there's character songs.
They didn't love
songs.
Me back. Yeah. Yeah, that's basically it. I love myself. I don't love myself. You know.
I love doing good things. I love doing bad things.
I love not loving. I love loving everyone. You know, all of these different
positivity.
Kinds of things.
Positivity.
That song, I sang that song with so much soul. So much soul. but so much soul, like you don't even understand.
If none of you understand that reference, please, after this, go to Mike Reinhardt's channel and look up positivity and look at the comments, and it will answer itself.
At any rate,
we both dressed up as animals before.
We actually have. You know, I was a bird the last time that we got to really do a big show, and then we did Beauty and the Beast, and then you were a multitude of animals. You were a
boar, a bear.
Yeah, it's a boar, a bear with wolf legs, I think,
yeah.
Was originally the concept. But Beauty and the Beast has always been one of my favorite shows. I mean, the music out of it, it gets trapped in your head, and then you sing it over and over, and we got to do that show with our very, very good friend, Miss Kiera Shackelford,
yeah.
Who played our bell.
Steve Elser.
Steve Elser.
Jared Riddle.
Oh, yeah, that was
yeah, which is so surreal,
cast.
Because when I was... Oh, when did we do Beauty and the Beast? You would know better than me because you know dates better.
05, 06.
05, 06. I was 8 and 9 years old. And I mean.
And you were Chip, right?
Yeah, I was Chip with Clayton St. Martin.
Yeah.
And it was just so surreal getting to an age where I'm the actual age of the Beast. Because when I did Beauty and the Beast, I was the actual. Because he's supposed to be 20, turning 21. I was 20 when I did the show. It was just. I grew up looking up to the guy who played the Beast and like, oh, he looks so cool. I want to do stuff like that. And then, you know, you turn into like a teenager. It's like, that's lame. I don't want to do that. But I remember just like loving Beauty and the Beast. And there was one night where there's a standing room only in the balcony and people were standing to watch a show. And like, that was amazing. And it's just so bizarre having to do a show and have some of the same cast be the, like, I played Chip once, now I'm playing the Beast, and
yeah.
I'm still got the original Cogsworth, Mrs. Potts, and Gaston.
And I'd put any, I'd put our Mrs. Cogsworth and our Mrs. Potts.
Mrs. Cogsworth.
Mr. Cogsworth and Mrs. Potts and all of you guys, I would put up against any professional cast. The reason is because of how much we love what we do.
Yeah, and just it becomes a family thing, and the people who come to do our shows over and over and over again. I mean, I've got extended family all over the country, but I always considered when we were doing theater like a family effort because we would all join together in an effort to put on a bigger show.
Yeah. So here are two clips from two songs from Beauty and the Beast. The first will be Jacob singing "If I Can't Love Her," the big triumphant Beast song at the end of the first act, and then Mrs. Melinda Reinhart singing "Beauty and the Beast," this is going to kind of take us back. So there'll be kind of those intermixed moments to where you just, you know, close your eyes and you feel like you're in the theater again. So we really hope you enjoy this next segment.
My twisted face, there's not the slightest trace of anything that even hints of kindness, and from my tortured shape, no comfort, no escape. I see, but deep within is utter blindness, hopeless, as my dream dies, as the time flies, love a lost illusion, helpless, unforgiven.
Cheaper, no point anymore if
if I can't love her. No spirit could win me, no hope left within me. Hope I could have loved her, and that she'd set me free. But it's not true. I can't love her. Let the world be done with me.
Tale as old as time, true as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared, Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same, ever a ever as before, and ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Tale as old as time, tune as old as song, bitter, sweet, and strange, finding you can change, learning you were wrong. Certain as the sun rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast. Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.
I don't even have the words to really describe. Like, just listening to that music puts me back into that summer. Puts me back. I mean, and I was tired after every show because of all the stuff I was doing backstage.
Yeah.
But I would definitely go back and do it all over again, the whole process. I learned a lot that summer.
I do it with less makeup.
Yeah.
No, you need more makeup now.
No.
You need more makeup now. Those two soundtracks that you heard, the orchestrations, came actually from when Mr. Gerald Reinhardt conducted the orchestra, and it featured a lot of RSMT alumni who are unfortunately not here with us anymore. With notable mentions, of course, being Mr. Gerald Reinhardt, John Bradford on the French horn, who was also the orchestra director for Maryville High School for a period of time. Trish Hales, who was playing the lead keyboard and lead piano. Unfortunately, we lost Trish Hales. Miss Georgia Nichols, although she wasn't in the pit, costuming and makeup was very prominently featured. Without the efforts of those folks, a lot of the things just wouldn't have gotten done because you had so much to do. And so, as we look forward to the future and we look forward to the growth of the RSMT family, we could never replace the shoes that have unfortunately been left empty for us. So we do want to wish a very heavenly happy Valentine's Day to those that we love but have unfortunately lost before we were ready to let them go. As far as looking forward to the future, though, we...
Oh, yeah. Complete segue. Hey, everyone you love is dead. Let's talk about next summer.
The thing is, this is how we talk to each other on a daily basis.
He has a really nice talk show voice. I don't.
This is how we talk to each other on a daily basis.
This summer, though. We plan
everyone
on doing
you love
a show.
Is dead, but let's talk about next summer.
In all seriousness, though, it is reassuring. Like when we did Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast and Hunchback, we saw a lot of these shoes emptying, and then a lot of people stepping up to the plate. I mean, they'll never fit the shoes, but they can stand in them with other people to kind of make up for.
Yeah.
And we had people. I mean, Jeremy helped us with makeup a ton.
Yeah.
We had Trish in Hunchback, but then somehow we manage every year just to kind of fill in these voids. And it's like, in a way, I never really get sad about it. Last summer I was kind of sad, but I never really get sad about it because it almost feels as if people aren't gone.
Yeah.
Because, you have this Ross legacy of people who've, put, their entire lives into this. And for me, it's like visiting, in a way.
Yeah.
And so this summer I would really like to visit again. And we anticipate doing a summer show, and knocking on all the wood in the world for that, because we want to respect and abide by all social distancing guidelines and things to keep everyone safe. But as vaccines start popping out and people get vaccinated and they're able to perform with low risk, I would really hope we'd get to do a summer show. And of course, before anyone asks, we have no idea what that would be. It would depend how many people get vaccinated, and it would probably be kind of an open audition, but are you vaccinated? Are you safe? Are you comfortable with doing this and being around other people?
Yeah. I mean, and we also, I know your parents are toying with the idea of potentially having to do something maybe smaller, mm-hmm. Cast-wise, because it's easier to do that contract tracing when you know where everyone else has been, when you know where they're going, because even professional theater hasn't really gotten back going yet, mm-hmm. And that's going to be the deal, is you're going to make this commitment. As to before, you're making a commitment, all right, I'm going to be at every rehearsal, and, to the best of my ability, I'm going to make it to the end of summer. But now it's like, I'm going to be at every rehearsal, but I'm going to mm-hmm. socially distance and be safe in my work day, and if I'm sick, now I can't come to rehearsal. And the moment that I know that I'm sick, I can't. And temperature tracing and cleaning everything down before and after. And now we can't share props. Your prop is your prop, which so
should be
the
case in the first place. But nothing set in stone. So we hope to keep everyone posted who's interested. We would really like to do another summer show. I especially would, because I feel like 2020 just didn't happen. Because usually I dictate, oh, this year happened because we did Hunchback. This year happened because we did, and last year we did a summer kids camp, and that was about it. And so I
and
just
I want to keep saying last year. Okay, last year we did Little Mermaid. Oh no, that was 2 years.
Two years ago. Yeah. So enough of us talking.
Yeah, but really quickly before we do get on to the less a little bit, you know, to do these things once again, we would really appreciate, you know, if you could find it in your heart to make any small donations or contributions to helping us out, getting, you know, back into the swing of things. Putting on a show is no small task, not only from the amount of work that goes into it, but monetarily it is not a small task, and we don't have a group of investors that just, you know, shell money to us to do this. So a lot of things are, you know, are self-bought or repurposed and repurposed and repurposed. And it's really cool for me, you know, seeing the things when I remember them being the first time that I saw them, and then going, oh no, that wasn't the Carlotta dress, that was the Hello Dolly dress, but it actually came from this and it was made from here. And so anything that you could, you know, contribute or donate, we would really extremely appreciate it, especially after this time. But we are looking forward to potentially doing some Carabonette variety show style things in March. So please look forward to that. Something very similar to, you know, the old Carabonette shows, to where you have the sketches and you have the music and, you know, you have all of these different things that come together for an evening of comedy and laughter, which is something I think we all very desperately need at this time. And so to give you a little teaser of that, we do have a Carabonette sketch that we're going to throw in there before we let you guys go. This is always one of my personal favorites to watch because it is just Mike and Melinda, well, being Mike and Melinda. we have some other things in there, some tributes and
your song. Can't forget your song.
Oh yeah,
your
that's favorite song. one of Mike Reinhardt's favorite songs for me to sing, because it's just so much fun. And then we would like to leave you with just our Valentine Day blessing, My Funny Valentine, being sung by Melinda Reinhardt. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining us this evening. If you enjoyed the show and you want to watch it again, give it about 15, 20 minutes and this show will go be posted back onto YouTube. And then you can share this show around wherever you want, to whomever you want. You can go back and listen to some of your favorite numbers. We appreciate everyone who's been watching, everyone who's been commenting, and you know, we hope
putting
to
us on their Snapchat stories.
And we really, from myself, from Jacob, from Mike, Melinda, and Cassidy, and Lucas, we hope to see you all very, very soon.
Happy Valentine's Day.
The real love song for you. Bless your beautiful heart, wherever you may be. Don't know your name, but I'm willing to claim you're the gal for me. Bless your beautiful heart, you're just as good as lost. I don't know, we ain't met yet, but I'm willing to bet, lest your eyes is crossed. Oh, I'd swap my gun and I'd swap my mule, though whoever take it be one big fool. Or I'd pay your way through cooking school, if and you say I do. Bless your beautiful heart, prepare to bend your knee. Take that vow, cause I'm telling you now, you're the gal for me. Pretty and trim, but kinda slim. Heavenly eyes, but oh that size. She's gotta be the right bride for me. Bless your beautiful heart, wherever you may be. Don't know your name, but I'm willing to claim you're the girl for me. You're the girl for me. I'm talking to you.
way. Oh, these doors are so heavy. Oh my. There we go.
Bert, you don't have to wear your mask out here. We're the only ones on the porch.
They told me that I had to wear it to protect old people like you.
You got there? Let me help you down.
Oh, give me a push in my rocker here.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
Here we...
Yep.
Get mine started again.
All right, I gotta get back there first. There we go. Whee! Ooh, zippity-doo-dah!
You were as perky as Georgie Jessel.
Yeah. You want to do something tonight?
Nope.
Oh, come on, Molly. I'm tired of just sitting around here rocking all day.
When you're 90 years old, Bert, this is a rock festival.
Well, I don't know about you, but I want to get out and do something. I can picture myself on a big Harley riding down the street with a surfboard and a beautiful blonde on the back. You can come too. And we're riding down to the beach. And when we get to the beach, we can hear the waves flapping up on the sand. Flapping up on the sand. Can you hear it, Molly? Can you hear it? Is this...
Wake up, swinger!
Wait, where's that? Not on the beach.
Well, you went to the doctor today. What did he say?
Who?
The doctor. You went to get your second vaccine today?
Yes, I went today to the doctor to get my vaccine.
And what did he say?
Who?
The doctor.
Oh, the doctor. I went to see him today. Got my second vaccine.
What did he say?
To me?
Yes.
Who?
The doctor.
Oh, he gave me a shot today.
Oh, I know, dear.
And he said he called me Stutz Bearcat.
Why on earth would he call you Stutz Bearcat?
Because he said I'm built like an old racing car.
He did he?
Yes, he did.
What, did you tell him you done run out of gas?
No. But he did say I had me a flat tire.
Feel better, Stutz.
I'm sorry, Molly. How's that feel?
Compared to what?
The doctor said I didn't have to slow down none, Molly.
Slow down? If you moved any slower, you'd be a statue.
I can see I'm sleeping in the living room tonight.
Well, that's your choice. Well,
it's my choice. I just as soon sleep in the kitchen.
Now, why on earth would you want to sleep in the kitchen?
Because I'm used to sleeping next to refrigerators. You know, speaking of the living room and kitchen, I thought I heard someone in our house last night, like a burglar.
A burglar?
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Well, we don't have much, so he'd just be wasting his time.
Yeah, that's true.
Then again, it could have been one of them peeping Toms.
Yeah. Talk about wasting your time.
The old coot. Sounded like you were having a nightmare last night.
Me? Night? No. No, no. Last night I was dreaming I had that woman that was on my motorcycle cornered in the living room down the stairs.
Well, that explains it.
Explains what?
Why, I kept hearing you holler, "Help me! Help me!"
Feel better, Klutz?
You know I'm just joshing, Bert. Well, You got the paper there. What's going on TV tonight?
Nothing. We've binged-watched all our shows. Now they've moved the office to Peacock, and we don't get Peacock. Well, I don't know. Maybe watch us an old movie here. Look, there's a Dean Martin movie. I like Dean Martin. He's a drinking man like myself.
There's a big difference between drinking scotch and drinking prune juice, Bert. Well, I about had it for today, so help me up.
It is 8 o'clock. It's way past our bedtime.
Oof.
There you go.
Gotta get myself ready for bed.
What you wearing tonight, Molly? Pajamas or a nightgown?
What's it to you?
I can still be turned on, you know.
Turned on? Nowadays, we're lucky if you can still find the switch.
Oh, Molly.
Is your